Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is a part of learning JavaScript with ServiceNow. Next topic is functions in JavaScript. So let's get into the topic. What is function in JavaScript? Function is a block of code which is used to perform some action. Function can be invoked by calling it via different ways. Function is defined with function keyword in JavaScript. Why we need a function in JavaScript? When a code is wrapped in a function, then it can be used anywhere in this script by calling same function. That means it can be reused. The same code can be reused. One of the major feature of a function is that is its own scope. For example, a variable declared inside a function and can also be used by script inside the function, and script outside the function cannot use the variable. That makes function more powerful. Now let's understand the syntax of the function. A JavaScript function is defined with a function keyword which is allowed by a name, that is name of the function, and parentheses. Then you can put only the curly brackets, and within these curly brackets you can put the code in JavaScript which you want to execute in it, and it can be any statement of any code you want to execute. Now the parenthesis after the name of the function, you can also have a different parameters, whatever the parameter, multiple parameters as well. Now once function is declared, you need to call the function to execute the code inside a function. So if you are declaring a function and if you are mentioning a code inside that function that you can invoke or call the function by invoking it with the JavaScript. So if you want to mention the name of the function, so whatever the function name you are using to declare that function, to invoke it in order to call it, you have to put the name of the function first, and then you have to put parenthesis, and in this way you can run code which you want to execute inside the function, which means overall you are invoking the function. Now if a function needs any parameter, then it parameter values can also be added and by mentioning them in the parenthesis. And even if you want to call the same function, if you want to pass the same parameters, you can also pass those parameters while you will call the function as well. So you can see that at the top we have function, the declaration of the function where we have function name, and then if you have to invoke the function, if you have to call the function, then you have to run the code which you have the inside that function. This is my personal developer instance. In order to declare a function, I will start with the function keyword, and then I use the any name. So let's say like person, I have used it. In order to declare the function, I have to use the parentheses. I have used the parentheses, and I have opened the curly braces. So in the between the curly braces, I will write a code. Let's say printing of some output. So maybe I'll do it as gs.print of. So I have written this gs.print code inside the function. So this is ServiceNow and ended with semicolon. Now I will run the script. So it will not print this output, and the reason behind it, as of now I am just declaring the function and the output. So let's run the and see if I will get some output or not. So I'll try to run the script. So here you can see it is executed, but it is executed with simple code, and it didn't saw any of the function declaration happen. That's it. But what action it has taken, whether it has taken run the code and which is inside the function do. What we do, let's go back to the script. This was not able to print because when we try to run this code, I will see that what kind of code I have used it in function, but this will not run basically. It will not execute the code because we are not calling it now. How can we call it? So once you declare a function, you have to call it so that you can run the code inside the function. So in order to call it, we just go a little bit bottom and I need to declare the function name. And if so, here we have used person, then I'll put parenthesis and declared with semicolon. So I'm done with this declaring the function. So and the expected output will be this is the service now. So what I will do, I'll just quickly go to this and run script and click on here. You can see that what we got, that is this is the service now, the output. Now exactly what happened when we will go back to the script. Now what exactly happened when you put a function? So you declared a function over here and you have mentioned the code inside the function, but if you are not call the function, that will not be executed. This code will not be, basically this code will not be executed at all. Now in order to execute the code, which is the code inside, you have to call the function, you have to invoke that function. How can you invoke the function? That is the line of code we are using here, that is person. Here you can see which we declared function name and with parentheses and declared with ended with semicolon. So it will definitely print and call the inside the function whatever the code we have declared it. Let's see how you can use parameters in that same function. What I can do, maybe I will provide a parameter for the function like name. And now we have this so this is the service now output. Maybe I'll capture the value of that particular parameter. So what I will do, I'll just try to declare here for the capturing and declaring the variable. I'll use this. I'll try to remove this one. Instead of service now, I'll just write a name, and I think it is perfect now. So we have definitely declared the function and with the person function name, but what we have to do, we have to pass the parameter as well. So how I will provide how we will pass this parameter, this is now this time you will learn the power of the function. So as of now I have just mentioned this is name, but initially when I mentioned this is service now, that means so static every time I will call that function, it will always print this as service now. But by using parameter, I mean giving it to flexibility. When I say flexibility, that means I can change the value of this parameter, and I can also change the output of these parameters which we declared here. On one thing here, I'll just use the parameter in the function where we invoking and calling the function. I'll just use it as service now. So on the output you can see it here. So if I try to run this code, you will see the exact you will see the exact output we got it earlier without parameter, but this was a static. So I will run this code, you will see this once again the output. You can see this it is printing it as the previous output, but here we are using the value of a parameter instead of a static value. That's the difference in the calling the function. You had to change the code, but here I can just use any value I want to print in output. So that is here we can use it in the function for the declaration. And if I change this as something as John. So here you can write the script and you can see it has been changed, and the parameter has been automatically changed. So that's the power of the function. And so basically the syntax is quite different. In the previous one, we didn't have any parameter, but in this one of our we are passing a parameter, which is really making that function more powerful, because we can change the value, we can see the output is different. Function return. Function is also used to calculate or execute some of the statements to return some of output. You can use the return keyword that way with any value or variable which holds some value, and this will return the output once a function is called. So whatever the function you have mentioned, and if you are running the code inside that particular function, you can return some output after running that code, and you can store that value outside the function as well. So whatever code you are running inside that function, you can execute that particular code, and if it is basically giving any output, you can return that output with return keyword, and then you can use that value outside the function. Let's understand this with an example. So we have a same function, and here we have parameters as name, which we declared earlier. We'll just try to remove this parameter. So we are actually printing directly inside the function. So but rather than printing it, it will return the output, same output. So what I will do, I'll just change this output from here, which we have declared earlier, and we will try to declare it inside the double quotes, and we have mentioned it. So here you can see it, we are using the gs.print instead of this. I will just use a return keyword, and with yes, I have declared it. So it's basically returning the string value, which is the declared here, and the string value, it's up to you. You can also put any variable. Let's say I can give it as var a is equal to, and it has you know, I'll make it as this is a service. No, I'll just cut and paste it. I have declared it, and so I'll just make it return a variable like this to get the output, and because a which holds some value, that is, this is the service no output, so that we are returning it out here. So we have to call the function outside. So I mean, we need to invoke the function. So what I will do on the person function name we declared here, if you want to execute, we need to return the output, but now exactly I can see that output. So in this case, what I will do, I'll just declare it as variable person, if any variable. So whatever in this case, what I can do, I can store that output in any variable, in any other variable. So whatever the value, like if I will try to declare it as a b, and the function name with parentheses I have already declared it. This will store the variable of a values that we have declared the variable here, and so what I will do just now, so I'll try to print it with the gs.print of b. Here we can use it like this. So basically what it is doing, this function name is capturing the value of returning the output of a variable, that is, this is a service node that we are storing it in b of the variable. So this b will be giving us output, and we are executing the function, and we are taking the output from b variable, which we declared here, that we are going to display it on gs.print to see the value what we are getting it.
So that's it, I think. So what I'll do, I'll just try to run the script or anything. Yeah, have to use the semicolon. So I'll just try to run the script. Here you can see the same output which we are getting earlier. So let's go back to the script. So you can use it with the parameter as well. You can do it that. So let's say I will give it a name in the function parameter. And instead of this, what I will do, I'll just remove this service now, and I'll just declare it as plus and name, and end it with semicolon. And in the function, what I will do, I'll just pass the parameter that is, let's say, like YouTube, just to have some output. I'll just pass the parameter. So what I will do, so right now I'll just go to the I have checked the code. Yeah, you can try to run the script right now. So you can see this, the output has been different. That earlier we are expecting it with the function, when the code in that function can be executed, when it gets executed, it can return an output which can use anywhere in your JavaScript code.
Function expression. Function can also be defined using an expression. Function can be stored in a variable. So you declare a variable like this as a A and assign a whole function expression to that particular variable, and then two semicolon. Now this variable can be used as function now. So if you have assigned this whole syntax, the full of whole declaration of the function, you have assigned to any variables, and then you can use that particular variable as a function anywhere.
Now in the same example, what we will do, we have this function over here which we declared it earlier. Now we will just assign this function declaration to a variable. So for that, I will just create a variable like where p is equal to function name with the declaration we have given it, and while declaring it, I need to mention the semicolon, then only it comes under the variable declaration. So now what I can do, in order to basically get this output from the function, because I have to run this, how exactly I can do this, if I have to print this value, then I have not used the person anymore. That means the function name anymore over here. Why this time I will use the variable which we assigned that function expression. So I will just use this variable as p, which we assigned the function variable, and then I will do just gs.print of b, which we already declared and ended with semicolon. Earlier the only difference is we are using the function as an expression. Now I'll just run this code. You will see the output, what it will be there. You can see the still the output is the same. So you can just go back to the script. So you just change the syntax. So might be the situation that when you have to use these kind of different things or different types of syntax we have in a function in JavaScript, depend on the kind of situation you are getting, or which is depends on the kind of use case you get to perform or to program the or perform the coding in JavaScript, or maybe doing programming in JavaScript or in ServiceNow.
Function hosting. Hosting is general behavior of JavaScript in which declaration can be moved to the top of current scope. As you can see the call of the function, and then you can declare it with it. So as you learned earlier, as a part of the declaration of a function and invoking the function, the syntax is the general syntax is that you have to declare a function, then you put the or then you call and call the function in JavaScript. It also accepts if you will call a function on the top, that means before the declaration you will do that, then you will write the function, that means you declare the function that is also acceptable in JavaScript.
So in this case, let's say I will just remove this variable keyword which we have given it, and just make it as a person and calling the function. What I can do now, so I'll just try to remove the complete condition and this thing. So what I will do, I'll just declare it at the beginning of the function. I need to mention the declaration. So what if I run this code, it still give me the same output without any issue. So let's say the change this output, like make it as service now, and I will try to print it to check the output. And so if I run the script here, you can see the output still it is working. If we try to change the order of declaration of the function, I can still call a function before its declaration. So I'm declaring it with a little bit bottom in the code. So what I am able to call that function, that means before its declaration.
Function self invoke. You can also self invoke a function in which you don't need to call it separately, and function can call itself. So as of now, you know, in order to call a function, you have to use the name of the function and then the parenthesis, or maybe it needs a parameter, then you provide the value of the parameter. But in order to self invoke a function, you have to put two parentheses together like this, and the first one and the second one like this. Now in the first parenthesis, you can put your whole function. So whatever function you want to write, whatever declaration you want to do, so in this case you don't have to call it separately. The only difference, whatever we learned till now, the difference is that we have called a function separately. But in this case, so you don't need to call it separately. If you will put these two parentheses, and in first parenthesis if you put your function, whatever the function you want to execute, if you want to run that code without calling a function, without calling the function in separate code, it will still be executed. So whatever the code you have written in the particular function, it will still be executed.
I'll just try to remove this one. So what I will do, I'll just declare the function. I'll give the function name as person, and open parenthesis and close curly bracket. We'll try to print any output, like let's take it as this service now. Yes, I have declared it. So in order to call this function, I will definitely have to use this name of the function outside the function, but I have to self invoke it. For that I can just put open parenthesis before the function keyword, and close parenthesis, and open close parenthesis I need to use, and I need to declare it. So once you are done, it will self invoke this function. If I run this code, you can see the output. You will get the same output as this is service now. So that means in this case, in this example, I don't have to call this function separately. I can just self invoke it. So it's up to you. It depends on the kind of use cases, the kind of requirement you get. Mostly you will definitely want to call it separately, but if you have to self invoke it, you can also do that in JavaScript.
Function parameters. We have already talked about parameters in a function. You can provide a multiple parameters in a function. You can perform some calculations with those parameters and return some output. So whatever values you will get by those parameters, you can use those parameters values to perform some calculation, maybe mathematical calculation, addition or multiplication, as we declared here. Then once you are done with the declaration of the function, you have mentioned the code of the function, then you can call the function with the function name and the parenthesis, and you can also pass the value of those parameters on the basis of which calculation will be executed. Calculation will happen in that particular function, because you have provided the values, those values will be used, it will be perform the calculation and addition and multiplication or subtraction, then you can return the output.
Let's say I have to return a multiplication of two numbers. Maybe I have to print it. So in that case, what I will do, I'll start with the function and with the keyword multiply. Here we have used it, and then what I will do, I'll do where, maybe var keyword, I'll just declare it var x is equal to, I'll call this function name which we have declared it over here as a comma b, and instead of a value I'll just use as a 3, and I'll just use it as 7. So I'll declare it with semicolon, and I have to print the values. Then I have to use the s.print of x, and we have given declared it as like this. So first it will send these values, those are parameters a and b, and with, if it will do the multiplication of this value, then provide the output. So if I run this script, I will give some output as 21. Maybe if I run the script and you can see the output. Here you can see I got the 21. I can also do, maybe I can also get other values, 300, if I change the parameter value which we have given it. Here you can see the multiplication of the value of output as 300. So what I will do right now, so after this, so you can do any execution of your script inside the function, or you can use the different parameters, so you can get different parameters and then send it to the function to do some calculation and return the output. Now this function will be utilized multiple times in any JavaScript programming, and also in ServiceNow scripting as well, because you will get a lot of values from the different different forms and different server side code, and you will definitely want to use those values and do some calculation, some kind of different execution. That is something you will do for different types of requirements. You will get it from your customer and clients. So that's how you can use a function in JavaScript, also in JavaScript programming in ServiceNow.